I come from a family where the females have definitely had breast cancer, and when I got an abnormal mammogram, I thought, yes, I've got it. I was really surprised how emotional I became on the day of the biopsy. And when the doctor was actually doing the biopsy, I just broke down into tears. And it was really a difficult day for me. A few days later, I was told that I had metastatic breast cancer, grade 3. My treatment involved 2 operations, 6 cycles of chemotherapy, and a course of radiotherapy. I had so many scans and procedures that it could actually fill a book. After I had finished the radiotherapy, I felt so detached. Fortunately, my breast care nurse, she realized that I had post-traumatic stress and referred me to see a clinical psychologist who specializes in cancer.
Unfortunately, Suzanne's condition is not unique. Breast cancer affects about 1 in 8 women at some point in their lifetime. And right now, the treatment that follows can often be long and stressful. In many countries, X-ray screening is done for breast cancer with mammography, but the number of clinicians required to keep this going is difficult to sustain. To tackle these problems, we worked with patients like Suzanne to explore how artificial intelligence might be able to detect breast cancer in screening mammograms. Our researchers are also looking into the applications of artificial intelligence for cancer treatment, and that work begins in partnership with Mayo Clinic. We're really excited to investigate whether artificial intelligence can help in these complex processes like planning of radiotherapy.
Over 1/2 of all cancer patients receive radiation as part of their overall cancer therapy. Radiation oncology itself is a very technology-driven field, and it's ripe, if not actually overdue, for AI implementation. So when Google Health approached us about collaborating on AI radiation therapy, we said absolutely. Radiation therapy is used to kill cancer cells. The first thing we do is take images or scans of the patient. That way we can identify critical structures in the tumor. The radiation oncologist, based on these scans, painstakingly goes and draws all these critical structures. These would be things like your optic nerves, your brainstem, your spinal cord. And that way, when we upload these to our computer models, we could avoid these critical structures and just target the tumor.
So this process of outlining the normal tissues as well as the cancerous tissues is called contouring. It has to be done very meticulously, and that can take expert clinicians 6 or 7 hours per case. We think artificial intelligence might have the potential to really streamline this process.
We're optimistic that AI will help increase the amount of time we can spend with the treatment plan itself and for the doctors to spend with their patients. Ideally, this would eliminate that agonizing amount of time patients wait to get their cancer therapy.
The hospital treatment took 9 months, and obviously that involved a lot of waiting for new appointments to come, waiting for the results of procedures to come. It just seemed endless, and I'm sure it would have been easier if it hadn't been so long. I was very fortunate in having a breast care nurse assigned to me who was always able to give me the time that I needed. But there were certain times when I wished I had been able to spend a little bit longer with my consultants.
Patient participation really empowers our research. It brings clarity to our mission and makes sure that we're learning from those with lived experience. This new study with Mayo Clinic will not actually take place in a clinical setting. We'll be studying the use of algorithms on de-identified data, images which you cannot trace back to an individual patient. We'll be beginning by trying to assess contouring in the head and neck. We're starting with this area of the body because there are many anatomic structures squeezed into tight spaces. If we can perform this delicate and difficult task in head and neck structures, we think it should be feasible to scale up the technology to other areas of the body and benefit as many patients as possible.
I'd always been aware that it is absolutely vital and crucial that patients are involved in cancer research, specifically in terms of partaking of clinical trials. Suddenly I found myself being involved actively in helping with the research, and I found it actually really cathartic. It was like the cancer, instead of being so much in me, came out, and I was able to use my experience to really be of use, I think, and that, I think, is empowering when you realise that you've got something to offer.
Patients come to Mayo Clinic to receive the best quality care. Our collaboration with Google Health will help us increase and continue that great quality care for our community, but also for everyone around the world. We hope that with this partnership, we'll be able to not only increase the quality, but increase the access of radiation therapy to patients around the world, which will improve cancer outcomes.
Google works at the cutting edge of artificial intelligence, and we believe that its applications in healthcare could assist doctors and caregivers and improve the accuracy and availability of many investigations and treatments. Our North Star is helping everyone live healthier lives, and we believe that with projects like this partnership with Mayo Clinic, we can do just that. Improve treatments for cancer patients by making the process faster, more efficient, and more precise. Accurate treatment plans can be accessible for far more people around the world.